An artist doesn't always make the entire story on the painting too obvious from the first glance you take, and you might be surprised how long you can look at one and still notice something different about it each time. Painters might also hide self-portraits or convey a story that happened in their life with other characters, as we're about to see. From possible portrayals of early UFOs to even a portrait that resembles Vladimir Putin in the 1400s. Here are secret messages hidden in famous paintings. But first, we asked you guys what your secret code name would be in our most secretive Secrets of the Secret Service video, and we got a few responses. The target would certainly seem to make sense, and the American Eye guy has a catchy ring to it. If you haven't seen that video already, be sure to check it out, and go ahead and subscribe too while you're at it. Number 13, Caravaggio, Beheading of St. John the Baptist. Many have heard of the famous Italian painter Caravaggio, who is known for creating many great masterpieces, and this is considered to be one of his most important. But there seems to be a secret message hidden in this painting that isn't clear unless you know about Caravaggio's dark past. It's believed that he actually murdered a man who went after his girlfriend in the same way. It was known that he had a temper, being described as touchy and provocative. 2 years later, after the alleged altercation with the man, he fled to Malta, where he was hunted down by the Knights Templar. It turned out that the man who he got into an altercation with was from the Knights of Malta, a Templar sect. Number 12, Les Demoiselles d'Avignon. While most of us may not see anything too shocking from this painting, Pablo Picasso was a revolutionary abstract painter, and he started gaining a lot of haters, especially for this masterpiece. Henri Matisse declared that this overshadowed his own artwork because of Picasso's portrayal of floozy women was getting way too much attention. Not only were the paintings of French working girls slightly shocking, but the geometric shapes and vivid colors surprised many. Many described this painting as being immoral, and artists were originally shocked that this went on exhibit. You wonder if he got asked by a few people to draw them like one of those French girls. Number 11, Madame X. Normally, people wouldn't find anything wrong with this image, painted by Jean Sanger Sargent, completed in 1884. This portrayal of an upper-class French aristocrat, Virginie Amélie Gautreau, ended up shocking the world. With people of that era being much more conservative than they are now, they believe that she was indeed too underdressed and her skin was so pale that it was thought to be morbid. He corrected the original, which had a fallen strap, which caused an uproar, but that wasn't enough. He just drew her like she was, and people weren't very happy. Number 10, Primavera. This painting seems to display quite a bit of female happiness at first glance, but there's much more to it. It was completed by Sandro Botticelli between 1477 and 1482, and financed by the rich Medici family. He was also responsible for the famous Birth of Venus painting, and it's believed that she pops up in this one too. Some people believe that Simonetta Vespucci was the most beautiful woman in Florence, and modeled not only for the Birth of Venus, but also for this one. What's also very interesting is that Sandro painted roughly 500 different plants in this painting, displaying a vast knowledge of botany. You have to wonder how far he was willing to go in order to make the best possible painting for the rich upper class of the Renaissance at that time. Myra. It might at first glance look like a beautiful painting of a pretty woman, but once you realize who she is, you'll realize that you're looking into the eyes of a cold-blooded killer. Myra is portrayed as an infamous child murderer from the UK. Some felt as though she shouldn't be hung up in museums, but some of the best art has no boundaries. This was exhibited in the Royal Academy of Art in London in 1997. What's even creepier about this is that the portrait is made up of entirely handprints of children. Protesters actually threw eggs at the portrait on the first day it was out. Hindley even sent letters from prison to have it removed. It wasn't just meant to be. Number 8, Picasso, the old guitarist. Traditionally, blue paint is the most expensive kind because it contains lapis, which is a deep blue rock that's highly sought after and needs to be imported to Europe. You can find it in rare works of art and even in the funeral mask of Tutankhamun for the eyebrows. Picasso went through a period where he was primarily using blue, and he produced some very eerie paintings. One of them, towards the end of his blue period, he managed to reuse a canvas and paint over a previous painting. If you look closely at the painting, The Old Guitarist, which is one of the more haunting paintings at this time, you can see the outline of a woman's face and figure. Some wonder who she was and why he decided to cover her up opposed to the other portraits. Number 7, Sistine Chapel. This photo here shows the creation of Adam and is a scene of the Bible when life was first given to Adam. But could there be some secret imagery here in this masterpiece? Some neuroscientists were examining the shape of the oval thing on the right side and believe it shows a very accurate depiction of the human brain. Many believe that this secret image was thrown in there due to the Catholic Church's criticism of scientific research at that time. Number 6. Man, Controller of the Universe. You probably wouldn't be too surprised if you saw this painting by Diego Rivera and found out that there was some hidden symbolism. It was originally made for the Rockefeller family, but they actually destroyed it when they noticed the portrayal of Communist Lenin in the photo that we see to the right. The destruction of this beautiful piece of art caused much of an uproar with the art community. A new mural was created on a smaller scale in Mexico City. However, in this new one, there's said to be some ridicule towards the Rockefeller family. There's an image of one of the Rockefellers drinking a martini, and possibly talking to a prostitute, some claim. Nelson's father was also diagnosed with syphilis at this time, so it would have been quite the jab. Also, if you look right above his head, that's what the bacterial infection actually looks like under a microscope. I guess that's what you get for destroying someone's artwork. Number 5. Bacchus. Created in 1595 by Caravaggio, it's being held in one of Florence's most beautiful art galleries in modern times, and many visitors might not even notice the hidden secrets within. It displays the Roman god of wine, Bacchus, drinking from a large glass. It seems like he's a little bit lonely and would enjoy the company of a goddess. But most people don't even notice the carafe sitting at the bottom left, which contains a small portrait of Caravaggio. It was first spotted in 1992 when a restorer was working on it. Caravaggio has curly dark hair, and some claim in this portrait he's holding onto a paintbrush. Modern technology actually confirmed the portrait's existence and got a close look at it. Number 4. Madonna with St. Giovannino. This painting is held in Florence, Italy, and was made in the 15th century by Domenico Ghirlandaio. It's one of the few paintings that UFO theorists claim to see an extraterrestrial object to the right behind Madonna. There's a man standing to the background shielding his eyes from the sun, clearly looking up at the sky. As soon as you zoom in even further, it clearly depicts what would look like a UFO or a flying saucer. If it wasn't a flying saucer, then what did Domenico try to portray? An angelic presence or divine cloud? They didn't have any weather balloons at this time, so the government couldn't be using this excuse in that case. We're curious to hear what you guys think this famous piece of art is portraying. Number 3. Arnolfini Portrait. There are likely more hidden messages and paintings than we even know about, and it might even take a magnifying glass to find them. And this double portrait is believed to show Giovanni di Nicolao Arnolfini, a wealthy Italian merchant who moved to the city of Bruges, and his wife is to his left. It was supposed to depict everyday life and living standards in the Netherlands. The portrait was also like almost having a marriage certificate at that time, and was so important not to mess up. But if you look a little bit deeper into the mirror of this painting, it's believed that the artist, Jan van Eyck, made another self-portrait of himself standing in the front of them. He also left his signature over the mirror, which means that he actually was there for this specific event. You might also notice the little dog at their feet too. This represents loyalty among the two, and it could have been used as a gift from Giovanni. If you look at him a little bit closer, you might even notice that he sort of looks a little bit like Vladimir Putin. Could this confirm that he's actually a vampire or what? Number 2. UFO or Angel. This painting here, made by the Dutch artist Ert van Gilder, depicts a scene in the Bible where Jesus was baptized. In the verse of Matthew 3:16, it's described where the heavens open up and the Spirit of God descends. Did they forget about the part about the UFO alien spaceship hovering over them? We all know what a UFO is capable of, and if it walks like a duck and talks like a duck, it's most likely a 9-foot-tall alien ready to enslave humans. Was the artist meaning to portray an extraterrestrial, or was it supposed to portray the heavens opening up? Either way, it's pretty strange. The fellows from Ancient Aliens, though, claim it's a clear portrayal of UFOs in ancient art, with light beams shining down on them. What do you think? And number 1, the Crucifixion. If that last one didn't seem too mysterious already, you should take a look at this one here, which was made in 1350 and hangs at a monastery in Kosovo. What's also kind of strange is that Vice President Joe Biden even came down to this Byzantine monastery where it's being kept. But for what reason exactly? Albanians had tossed grenades at it, and it's even been a monastery that's experienced much political unrest. Whether it's meant to depict aliens or some kind of sun and moon god, we're not sure, but it looks awfully suspicious. It almost appears as though a small human is flying a circular vehicle of some sort. The person in the moon-shaped object is looking back at the vehicle behind him, almost as if he's being chased by the sun. Did people back in that day actually believe that aliens might have had some kind of control of celestial bodies that we see in the sky? Skeptics believe it's just personifying the sun and the moon and not depicting aliens, but what do you believe?
Whoa, now that was a crazy video. Be sure to check out more of our videos right here on American Eye. We got hundreds of them, so watch them.